George Bai, a really interesting announcement you have for AirVenture this year, and it's a four-seat version of your electric airplane. Tell us what's going on.
That's right. So we're taking the two-seat concept under the Part 23 certification program, a little bit of a stretch, and additional batteries, and we think we've got a very capable four-seater that we're ready to launch.
What kind of performance are you looking for out of the four-place airplane?
So the two-seat airplane is a three-hour endurance. The four-seat will be 4 hours of endurance. 130 knots for the four-seater, 120 for the two-seater, so we're increasing range, endurance, and speed.
Now, you're looking at this being a Part 23 certified airplane. What are some of the challenges in certifying an electric airplane?
Well, the biggest thing is this is a pioneering event. This has not been done before. So we're working together with the FAA, the new Part 23 certification program, and it's literally pathfinding this great new propulsion system.
And what's involved in that propulsion system?
So electric motor up front, and we have a cooling system that's behind that, motor, inverter, and controller, followed by the battery management system, and then the battery packs.
So the four-seat airplane obviously is going to be a cross-country aircraft. What are some of the differences that a pilot might see when they get in that they would from a reciprocating engine?
Oh, that's great. So electric is very much like a turbine type of experience, so turboprop, turbojet, turbofan. So it's much, much more linear, very, very quick on torque and response. The four-seater is an IMC-IFR kind of an airplane, as opposed to a VFR trainer for the two-seater. So it's a much more of a full general aviation type of experience.
Do you have an avionics partner yet for the four-place?
We're in talks with Avadyne, and we look forward to working together with them.
Now, when you go back to the two-seater for just a moment, because I know that's a training airplane, but not everybody who trains in that airplane is also going to be flying an electric airplane through their entire career. How do you make that transition between training an electric airplane and then going to a reciprocating engine?
Every airplane, as you progress in your professional training process, involves transition training. It won't be any different with electric as it would be with any progression to a higher power, more advanced aircraft. This is the two-seater right here behind us. It has every bit of the appearance of a conventional aircraft except for the very sleek, low-drag nose. But the inside, the avionics, and the training experience is a high-tech general aviation two-seat trainer.
How long do you expect it will take to get the four-seat airplane certified?
We want very much to have it be an immediate progression from the two-seater to the four-seater. So we've got common systems, common layout. It's a 36-inch stretch, but we're using the same wing to the best of our ability. We're going to keep every component either the same or similar with the additional payload capacity.
And do you have an estimated price on it yet?
$249 for the two-seater and $349 for the four-seater.
Well, George, thanks very much for taking some time to talk with us on Aero-TV. We're looking forward to a great show.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Aero-TV is brought to you by...
Since 2001, MGL Avionics has produced avionics for experimental and light sport aircraft. The flagship product is the IEFIS, a comprehensive next-generation flight, engine, and navigation instrument designed to meet the demands of the modern pilot. See more at www.mglavionics.com.
Progressive Aerodyne C-Ray Adventure offers Rotax 912 power, a basic instrument panel, and radios. Fly it away for under $120,000. Visit cray.com for more details.